Acara selanjutnya akan dilanjutkan oleh pemateri yaitu Pak Angga Jovanka. Waktu dan tempat dipersilakan.
Hi everyone. Before I'm started, am I audible for all of you guys?
Yes. Sure.
Cool. Let me share screen myself for a moment. Hoss, would you mind to let me share screen?
Wait. Untuk Pak Satya, untuk minta tolong untuk Pak Angga dijadikan host untuk dapat men-share screen-nya. Terima kasih. Mohon maaf untuk host dapat menjadikan Pak Angga menjadi host untuk dapat men-share screen-nya. Terima kasih.
Yeah, okay, cool. Thank you for host to make me able to share screen. Okay, one moment.
Okay, sir.
All right, is everyone able to see my screen?
Yes, sir.
Cool. Hi everyone. My name is Angga. So I'll be your your own narasumber di hari ini. Jadi hari ini kita bakal campur aja ya bahasa Inggris dan bahasa Indonesia. Maybe some of you are still new with this typical of debating. So mixing is going to be one of the way for us to make the debate or maybe to make the seminar much fluent in the future. Jadi di sini adalah cara mengadjudicating British parliamentary. So British parliamentary itu salah satu platform atau salah satu bentuk debate yang digunakan di most of the times yang sekarang pakai. Jadi lebih common itu ada namanya British parliamentary and then the Asian parliamentary and then the Australian parliamentary. But today I will more focus to the BP adjudicating. So please focus and please feel free if you have any questions in the future. So let's move into introductions. And most of the debating, and commonly in Indonesia or maybe focusly in Medan, there's two parts of parliamentary, which is British parliamentary and Asian parliamentary. So in British parliamentary, there is 2 versus 2 versus 2 versus 2 teams that appearing, and in Asian parliamentary is only 3 versus 3. So between the British parliamentary, the difference is you facing against the other three teams that have the opening bench and the closing bench. And but in Asian, you only have one each side of bench, which is pro and then contra itself. So both of the difference, it coming from how you adjudicating is also there. When you try to adjudicating Asian, you doing as simple as how you do competitive. Jadi kalau di Asian tuh mudahnya ngejuri cuma yang mana yang menang, pro atau kontra. That's all. That's how you see the debate. But in British parliamentary, there is 4 teams that you need to adjudicate, and you have to ranking in from 1 until 4. So in British, there is opening government, there is opening opposition, there is closing government, and then there's closing opposition, which all of the benches may have a different statement, may have a different argument, which lead into the debate or maybe lead into the motion itself. So the difference is you need to see the contribution based on what each bench gives. Jadi itu yang lebih fokusnya di British. Lebih di mana kontribusi dari argumen mereka, dari statement yang mereka katakan. Atau logically speaking, apa yang harus dilakukan terhadap mosi itu sendiri. Jadi itu yang biasa terjadi kalau misalnya di British parliamentary. So you have to make a differentiated when you want to judging, because this is also means that you have a typical of way and you put the mindset how you will judge the British parliamentary and Asian parliamentary. Karena ini yang bisa menjadikan perbedaan bagi mereka berdua. Okay? I think most of you already know this because it's the basics of how you understand British parliamentary. So from each role, when you see the prime minister lead the opposition and then deputy prime minister deputy lead the opposition, you may see this at the opening house. Atau biasa disebut sebagai opening government sama opening opposition saja. And then there's a member of government, and then there's a government whip, and in the same time, there's a member of opposition, and then opposition's whip. Most of the time, we call it as a closing bench, yang biasa ada closing government sama closing opposition. So, if you already know and very common with the British parliamentary, you must know each role speak. For the starting point, prime minister's duty will try to create a definition, will try to create a characteristic to what's going to be happening in the motion, and then they try to create a preemptive action. That's almost the same thing of coming from the opening bench. But the differentiate for you when you see the closing bench, like how the member of government will try to make a differentiated with opening half, or maybe to create a deeper analysis that coming from the opening half, or maybe have a better response towards what happened in this motion. And you see this part of contribution. And then you see the how WIP will be focusly into responses, and then how you see WIP will be much more reliable to glorification to their own teammates. So this happens in the speaker's role in British parliamentary. So please take a note that if you want to do adjudicating, you have to understand that each speaker's role from the beginning. If you miss it out and you don't know what they need to be done, it's going to be very hard to be achieving the adjudicating because it needs a lot of practices from the beginnings. And theoretically, it really depends on how you see those speakers' roles. Even that the arguments or maybe even that there's a lot of the questions coming from the each speakers, which is we need to see from each speaker's roles and also need to focus on the contributions that may happen. So this is how you make the biggest point that you need to be done. Karena kalau misalnya kalian lupa dari setiap roles itu harus ngapain, itu bakal membuat hasil adjudicating kalian bakal lebih bias dan nggak jelas most of the time. Jadi lebih bagus kalau misalnya kalian hafal beberapa posisi dan apa yang dilakukan tugas-tugas mereka. Itu yang lebih menguntungkan sebagai if you adjudicating. It will make your adjudicating much more fluent and it will make the most possible subjective idealistic result in the analytic. Jadi itu yang lebih enak kalau misalnya kalian ingin adjudicating because BP adjudicating in the future. Okay, moving on. So if you want to become adjudicator, what needs to be done from the beginning? So generally in adjudicated, there's only two points that I think that you need to be done. First, you need to be a blank paper as possible. And the second is you need to know the common knowledge. That's the two things that I think that most of adjudicators need to be done. But what does it mean if you're a blank paper? Blank paper itu bukan berarti kalian nggak tahu apa-apa dan langsung tiba-tiba mengkosongkan diri apapun yang mereka bilang itu pasti selalu benar. No. Be a blank paper means that you see the contributions from each statement or maybe each argument that appear coming from whatever that the bench said. You have to see the motions and then you have to see which part of the statement, which part of the argument that really reliable and attached with this kind of particular motion. Jadi let's say that this house believe that the simple way is this house believe that KFC is delicious rather than McDonald's, for example. If you be a blank paper, you have to see how opening governments and closing governments see the comparatively with this actor model such as KFC itself, and then they want to compare itself with how opposition side at house, we see the MACD is going to be much more better. So when you try to see as a blank paper, you need to be as subjective to see from which part of them will be the ones that going to be inserted in their own arguments. Jadi di saat itulah yang kalian mengerti bahwa blank paper yang dimaksud adalah kalian itu harus benar-benar mendengarkan dari apa yang keluar dari kata-kata mereka, dan itulah yang harus kita adjudicate daripada hal-hal lain. And then second is no common knowledge itu yang dimaksud adalah kalian harus mengenal salah satu hal-hal umum. Hal-hal umum yang harus diketahui itu seperti hal-hal yang diberikan dalam suatu mosi itu sendiri. Let's say that this house will impeachment Trump because of the actions that happened. Nah, di saat itu kalian harus tahu bahwasanya apa yang terjadi dengan kasus-kasus Trump. For example, Trump create a riot in the White House, and then Trump create a lot of the discriminations, and then they create a unknown policy, for example. Jadi kayak common knowledge yang harus diketahui, tetapi tidak boleh dimasukkan ke dalam adjudicating itu sendiri. Jadi yang tidak boleh dimasukkan adjudicating itu sendiri adalah kalian tidak boleh tiba-tiba memaksa salah seorang peserta harus membawa hal-hal yang kalian kira itu benar. That's wrong. Karena itu hal-hal yang generally adjudicating need to be known, bahwasannya kalian harus tahu common knowledge yang ada sekarang aja. Tetapi nggak boleh secara langsung masukkan bahwasannya, iya, ini yang benar, lu harus bawa ini. That's have your own time, you have your own time to giving that, but not when you're trying to adjudicating. Karena with adjudicating, you just need to see the reality that happens in the debate. For example, that if you want to expect that this house will impeachment Trump, and then you want to see that how the policy, and then the riots, and then the most cases that happen in Trump. But in reality, the debate talk about how the right wing and left wing have been faces each other and they bring clashes in the end of the day. It means that you're not expecting them, but it means you need still to judging those kind of relevant idealistic of the debate that they think is much more reliable and much more important, but at the same time, you have to know what is going to happen when the Trumps appear in right wings, for example, and what happens if Joe Biden in left wing. that need to be characteristic from them, for example. And then you have to create a good generalization that this is the reality, that the common knowledge that I need to know also. So it means that EJU itu nggak langsung terlalu bodoh, tetapi mereka itu langsung mengenal hal-hal yang lebih umum yang juga dibicarakan orang-orang. So that happens that for all educating need to be done. So this is the basic of you educating, which also means that you need to have a lot of experience, not only if you're in the educating, but you also need a lot of experience in debating. Because in a debating, you will find a lot of the flaw from your speech, for example. You will know how to see the response, and then you will know to see how to create a subjective idealistic. So I mean, that's how you want to make a good educating. Just put it on your reality. It doesn't jatuh langsung ke lapangan. So that's one of the ways. But this is the most general educating that you need to become. And this is common mistakes that happens. Common mistakes yang dimaksud ini adalah common mistake di saat mereka melakukan educating. Which is two things. Step in sama unfair. Unfair ini will be most likely sama ke objective. Okay, let's go to the step in. Common mistake yang coming from the step in ini adalah salah satunya di saat kalian memasukkan general common knowledge kalian. Let's see kalau misalnya, let's see the motions that this house will still the same. That's how this house will impeach Trump. And then they talk about the different things that you're not into it. For example, that you're trying to talk, they try and talk about those kind of democracies and then left wing and right wing. But when you're trying to adjudicating, you see there's a little bit tipping point coming from the government or maybe opposition side of the house, and you're trying to stepping in, which means you try to input some things in there. When you try to input some of the ideal argument that you think is fit, it's a very common mistake that can appear from adjudicating, because that is not the duty of adjudicator to putting your argument in the meantime when you're trying adjudicating. You have your time when you want to give a feedback in the future. So please do keep in mind that you need to see the reality of the debate. You need to see what happens in the debate in that time, and then you have to see the reality what going happens in the current status quo, which is happen in that kind of typical motions. So step in is the very common mistake that happens in adjudicating. So most of the adjudicator will see this is not unrealistic. They see this is not me, let's say, and I will like to putting some of there, and then they just unlikely to do it in the middle of the adjudicating. So that's the most common thing that happens. And we think that it's very common mistake happens in adjudicating. And second is unfair. Unfair means that they just seeing as one-sided motions that it's going to be easily winning by those sides. Let's say that there's an unknown motion that appearing, let's say there's a legalization of marijuana. And then in the same time, you see that it's going to be much more logical if you are not legalizing marijuana, because logically speaking, marijuana is an illegal drug. And you just simply neglecting all logically statement coming from the other benches that trying to amplify that glorification of legalizing marijuana is possible. But in the same time, because you see that it's the common knowledge of marijuana is illegal, you create unfairness, and you just simply glorifying the reality of the illegalization. So I think that's basically unfair, because you just simply thinking logically that it's not going to be exist, it's not going to be accessible, and people cannot easily accept it. It's unfair for you if you're not seeing what is the basis ground, and then you cannot see how the argumentative and idealistic that each bench will be trying to give. Because, you know, when every debater is trying to give for all type of argumentative, when they try to give it all statesmen, they're trying to convince judges that it will work, and it's also just the process and then the result that will make a most probability for all people will be much more reliable. Let's say that's the same thing that happens when you're trying to legalize marijuana. And you see, just because of your own common knowledge that thinks that marijuana is illegal, you're just neglecting those ideas. judges need to see the process, judges need to see the progress, and also judges need to see how the statement that coming from them will be able to create a contributions to the motion, not contributing to your own individuality. That need to be done. So that is a common mistake that most of adjudicator that need to be done and need to be, you know, need to be neglecting for those kind of mistakes. Not only happens from the local adjudicating, for example, but it also maybe come from national, international judges that seeing this as common, typical that happen. But I do believe that most of the judges that be into the national scales and also goes to the international already try to mitigate those kind of mistakes. So I do believe that just try to become a practicist, just try to become. So this is just a tips that coming from you. So it's not going to be very fluctuative in the end, and it will create a dynamic result if you want to become a good adjudicator in the future. So after you just finish this, after you finish the adjudicating, you already know role speaking of how from coming from opening government, you know, coming from opening a position, and then you know coming from closing governments and also closing oppositions. And then in the meantime, you already finished the debate, you need to do discussions. When you are become a chair, you try to create a result that's very subjective to your own panels and maybe like panels and training. And at the same time, if you are a panel, you are trying to become a best idealistic and reasonable that why your you know, why your result is very subjective. So when you're trying to giving a, if you're a panel right now, the first thing that you need to do is don't be afraid when the other judges have a different decision, because it commonly happens when you're judging in the first time. Let's say that chair giving opening government first, but in the same time that you are giving opening government fourth, means that you very have a difference, you have a difference decisions that will, well, that will implementing that your adjudicating is stuck, for example. Don't be afraid, but because there's possibility that chair maybe don't see what kind of contributions that not being seen from you. So I think that's how you need to see the be brave that I mean, or that I want to become. Because in the same time, when you see the differentiating and then why the reasonable is that you put forth in the opening government, for example, and then it's much more reasonable, there's a possibility that chair will try to convince you and wants to change your decision. There will be possibility, but even if there is still a low possibility because most of the chair have a very you know, have a good experiences, and then they most likely know about it. But there will be a possibility that you will find middle answers. And for example, that if you're trying to be very good reasons that why opening government fourth, but in the same time chair see that it's going to be have a good decision for me first, there's a possibility that maybe they will change it to second, or maybe it was it's a third, but it depends on the how the discussion is going to be appear. Because that happens in the Kalangkatu school. And then you see there's a little bit of differentiate, just a two and three, and then you create a discussion, but you still want your decisions is going to be, goes up, because you see that's much more reasonable from you to make a decision in there. It's okay to be a split decision, and it's okay, and if you want to do unanimous, if you're just feeling like, okay, I'm easily to be swayed. If you try to become a split, which means split here, you are agree with chair, but at the same time, you are disagree with him, which means I'm okay with my decisions and just do voting. Itu pasti banyak bakal terjadi di British Parliamentary. Ada juga voting yang sekarang. Apalagi kalau votingnya itu jumlah jurinya itu in grand final, let's say that there's a seventh and then there's ninth. There's be a lot untuk melakukan discussion. Jadi lebih dalamnya itu kita ngelakuin namanya voting. Nah, di saat voting itu, you try to find the apa tuh namanya hal yang lebih mendasar ataupun hal-hal yang menengah dalam sebuah discussion itu. Let's say there from 9 people, 8th believes that opening government first, and then the 9th person see the opening government goes to 4th. Ya, mau nggak mau yang 9th-nya ini harus melakukan reasonable. That's why di saat 8 orang ini ngasih dia first, kenapa dia berani kali ngasih 4th, dan dia masih harus reasonable. Tapi ya, yang dilagai itu 8 orang yang which is going to be tough if you are trying to change decision. Jadi itu hal-hal yang terjadi. So don't be afraid even you have a different decisions with the other judges. You're trying to create a discussion. You're trying to find the result. Not try to become the show up. You're not going to become a star there. Karena tujuannya itu mencari result-result yang benar-benar mutlak untuk dalam suatu debat itu. Karena itu tujuannya dari discussions yang ingin dibuat itu. Nah, jadi this is the very first thing that you want to become if you are BP adjudicating. Don't be afraid. Just give your result, whatever it is, one from first until fourth, and then you are trying give you're giving your reasonable access idea or reasonable arguments that why you winning the side of the bench that you are trying to giving win. Okay, so just be brave. Because I do believe most of the chairs, if you're a panel, will be try to give you some insight if you have a different decision. And then when you try to have a discussion, you have a right to ask feedback from the other judges. Let's say that if you're a trainee, because you're a trainee, you just put some result, but you're not have a chance to give any reasonable. Let's say you not have a chance giving a feedback. So I think in that time, you have a chances to see the feedback, and then you have a chance to ask the chair, is there something wrong with my decision, or is there something wrong with my reasonable? Most of the chairs in current status quo right now will give you a feedback whatever happened. So the feedback will be very diverse from each judges. Karena pasti judges yang kalian jumpai itu mungkin nggak sama, karena kalian pasti, if your panel, jumpa sama chair-chair yang berbeda, dan di saat itu kalian harus mengumpulkan informasi sebanyak-banyaknya. Informasi mengenai bagaimana sih ngejuri versi mereka secara individual. And if you see those feedback is fit with you, and it's reasonable and able to be bring in the real debate, yeah, you make it as a part of your knowledge. You make it as part of your material if you want to become adjudicating in the future. Karena di saat itu salah satunya kalian bakal mendapatkan sebuah insight cara mengadjudicate yang lebih baik lagi. Yeah, when you're trying to adjudicating, there will be diversity sih memang. Karena yeah, if you're trying to adjudicating from the point of view, for example, I'm judging in Nepal, and then you just see the point of view of Indian judging, and then you see the point of view how Philippines debating. And there's a lot of the point of view that may have a different spectrum from your point of view. So I think you need to learn more about it, and you will easily know the international scale in the same time. Atau yang paling mudah aja, misalnya ngejuri di lomba-lomba nasional aja dulu deh, if you have a capability. And, or maybe the lowest part is you're judging in the local part. Ngejuri di lokal itu aja with all of your friends around you, I think you will be have a lot of chances to giving the feedback. Karena pasti edu-edu kalian itu adalah kawan-kawan kalian sendiri, and they will be happy to give you a feedback. Well, even if it's a little bit a sense of reluctant karena kawan kalian sendiri. So that's how you want to get the good, proper adjudicating these are kind of discussions. So those things that you need to be done is don't be afraid whatever it takes and ask feedback from the other judges. Okay? Judgesnya itu bakal baik banget karena pasti semua akan bakal ngasih. That's coming from me. And if you're chair, don't forget if some of your panel asking for feedback, be a good chair and be a good judges also in the same time. Karena pasti ada moment bisa kalian share, kalian itu merasa panelnya itu lebih baik daripada kalian. Dan di saat itu malah panelnya minta feedback. Ya, kalian harus memberikan insight versi kalian, tetapi ingat, harus berkoneksi and intertwine with how the debating it should be. Karena ya, burden chair itu memang tinggi sih. Karena burden chair itu selain menguji debatnya itu, kalian harus mengumpulkan decisions yang benar-benar reasonable, that there's possibility that you may change the decision, and then in the same time, kalian harus membuat sebuah personal feedback untuk debaters, at the same time mungkin judges yang ingin bertanya. Apalagi kalau misalnya it's very encouraging if trainee of the chairs in the very beginning. Karena trainee itu benar-benar orang yang benar-benar lagi belajar debat kan. Jadi pada saat mereka trainee dan belajar debat, dan cuma dikasih decision saja, tapi nggak dikasih waktu untuk converting or maybe create oral adjudication, ya di saat itu kalian harus belajar a lot dari chair-nya itu. Apalagi chair-nya mungkin prominent in that circuit. Nah, makanya itu saat itu kalian harus belajar. Okay. The next part is oral adjudication. Okay, this is going to be the toughest one. Karena if your oral adjudication, this is the reality that happens that you need to be done if you are a chair. And this is the possibility that panel doing this, if chair has lost vote and you need to make a reasonable amount that able to sway all the judges. So there's three part if you're doing OA. The three part is going to be tough is the general comment, which is also recommended, and then the ranking part, and the last one is your own personality, be confident. So in oral adjudications, most of the format that every adjudicator giving is general comment, and then ranking, and then the reason that why you're giving the results. So in oral adjudications, there's chair not giving general comments. There's part of the chair that will not give a general comment because most of the general comments that they believe will appear when you're giving a feedback. It's okay. It depends on the adjudicator. But most of the time, adjudicators need to give a general comment because general comments means that a new insight for a debater that what they will bring in the motion. Let's say that the very simple motions that appear is this house, let's say the same things that this house will impeachment Trump. And then because the part of the realistic of what motions exist is the Democratic and then against the Republicans. Let's say that happens in the reality of debate. But when you see there's a good, still another tipping point that they need to be bring, let's say there's a general comment is necessary. The general comment, for examples, like giving how the Trump impeachment is not going to be working, and then it's much more reliable if you see the cases of what happened in creative of impeachment Trump because of the policy, because there's a lot of the contradictions appear, because Trump like to make a conflict with the others in terms of social media. So I think the general comments that need to be necessarily bring for all of you guys, focusly for the chair, need to be done. Jadi di saat inilah kalian chair lebih upper untuk memberikan kasih tahu bahwasanya ada loh hal-hal yang bisa lebih didebatin dan bisa lebih menarik untuk dibahas daripada satu side itu aja. That maybe the possibility that happens. Karena di general comment ini, most of the debater will try to find a lot of information in there. And it means that you're able to put your own common knowledge in there, but not putting them as a part of your adjudicating. There's a difference, ya. Kalau misalnya general comments-nya itu memasukkan common knowledge yang kalian punya setelah debat itu selesai, dan kalian merekomendasi kepada mereka. Tetapi bukan bagian dari hal yang harus di adjudicating di saat mosi itu muncul atau di saat debat itu mulai. So that's the difference. So try to keep it note that what is happened in oral adjudication need to be accessible for all of you. Okay? So most of the times that ada EJU yang melakukan general comments, ada juga EJU yang enggak melakukan general comments. Dia bakal langsung lanjut, "Oh yeah, thank you for the debate and I think it's a good debate. So let's go to the rank." Ada yang langsung ke ranking. Jadi dia langsung ke ranking, setelah dia ke ranking, reasonable, tapi reasons dia itu panjang, kayak let's take 20 minutes, dan di saat bersamaan, ada debaters yang minta feedback, ya dia bakal ngasih general comment-nya di situ. Di situ dia bakal mengasihkan feedback, lu harus buat kayak gini, lu harus bawa nggak hanya impeachment aja, tanya aja tentang gimana kayak Middle East sekarang itu harus juga ikut bertanggung jawab gara-gara mereka banyak konflik di situ, atau kenapa Israel for example and then Palestine that doesn't finish the conflict, ada war trade yang terjadi bersama China and then US that also need to be bring dan tidak diselesaikan oleh Trump contohnya, itu yang terjadi. Jadi jadi hal-hal yang common knowledge yang kalian punya itu baru masukin ke dalam, nah, di saat itu feedback itu bakal lebih berguna. Okay, that's the thing. And then second is, you need to starting from every part of ranking from fourth to first. Jadi di saat kalian meranking the results, and then you see, you already get the points, you start from fourth until first. Itu yang paling common yang harus dilakukan. But the very the very complicated things that happens when you try to fourth to first, jangan sesimpel, ya kamu fourth gara-gara kamu kurang bawa analisis. Okay, yang ketiga, kenapa kamu juara tiga? Jangan kayak gitu. That's not recommended. Bakal dijelekin sama debatersnya. Nanti lu kayak, lu gak pada ngejuri ya. Pasti kayak gitu. The most things that you need to be done is when you see from fourth until first, you do a compare like why fourth sama third bisa menang third. Third ke second, kenapa second bisa menang, second sama first, kenapa first bisa menang. Dan dia bisa overwhelm the debate. Dari situ aja. Misalnya start from fourth, let's say the very simple is, okay, misalnya kayak OG satu, OG-nya first, OO-nya second, third-nya CG, CO-nya fourth. The simple analysis. And then you go to the fourth, okay, why I give CO fourth? It's because the argument is not credible. Let's say the argument is not attached to the reality that happens in the motion. It's not being given and then not be brought in the other debate. Let's say there's not giving a good response atau etc. Nah, setelah kalian kasih alasan kenapa dia dapat four, you jumping and comparative that, and in the same times, why I'm giving CG in the third place rather than CO? And then means that you're trying to compare CG sama CO. Ini yang bakal lebih complicated memang terjadi. It happens also in discussion. Tapi yang di discussion itu bakal ada bantuan karena ada orang-orang yang masih ingin mendoakan diskusi dan mencari sebuah jawaban siapapun itu. Tapi di saat kalian oral adjudication, you are being alone to see what is happens in the debate if you are chair. Karena ini tantangannya lebih di chair itu sendiri. Jadi kalian mulai dari third, misalnya kayak, okay, why are you giving third CG rather than CO? Because we do believe CO and CG have a difference in their own responses. Response from CG able to upper hand from CO, that's one. And maybe there's the differentiate that how CG able overwhelm CO in terms of the argumentative. And then there's also the part of how CG able to create the determinations and have the much more reliable argument rather than CO. Maybe hal-hal yang kayak gitu. Yang bisa membedakan CG sama CO. It's tough. Yes, it is tough. Karena ada beberapa debater yang bakal nggak terima. Nah, di saat itu, yang harus, the last part is be confident. Karena pasti ada aja debater yang dengki. Memang kata-kata yang jahat, tapi memang ada yang dengki. Dengki yang dimaksud ini adalah dia dapat fork, pasti dia ngasih edu feedback kita rendah. Then of course there will be edu feedback in British parliamentary or maybe all of the parliamentary to make sure they have a credible adjudicator. Di saat kalian udah nge-edu sampai mencari jawaban yang paling mutlak, udah mendapatkan hasil yang tepat bersama edu-edu lain, tiba-tiba di saat kalian ngasih fourth dan kalian merasa udah ngasih reasonable argument and then reasonable decision that why he get fourth. Tiba-tiba kalian dikasih dua di saat adjudicating feedback, or maybe tiga. Terus kalian bingung loh kenapa aku dikasih dua, tiga. Nah, di saat itu kalian jangan langsung rendah diri, karena itu mungkin coming dari satu timnya aja. Di saat itu kalian di CO itu cuma dikasih dua atau tiga, tapi di tim-tim lain, misalnya di OG, OO, atau CG, kalian bisa dikasih 9, atau 8 atau 9. Nah, di saat itu, pasti yang lain itu melihat bahwasannya, oh, EJU ini credible. This EJU is prominent. So, I think his reason is much more reliable. Nah, di saat itu, kalian benar-benar harus confidence aja. Walaupun dia ada ngasih rendah. Yang sakitnya lagi, di saat dia ngasih 2 atau 3, dia nggak minta feedback. This is the common things happen for all debaters that only giving the low score, but doesn't asking why I get those part, and then what is my mistake as adjudicating. Karena itu yang bakal ngebuat sebuah adjudicating itu lebih berat. So when you doing oral adjudicator, when you doing oral adjudication, be a reasonable adjudicator. Kalau kalian misalnya nggak sanggup ngasih OA-nya itu blak-blakan tanpa ada notes, buat aja notes. Pasti itu yang harus dilakukan. Karena if you're adjudicating, you need every typical of notes that you have. Kalau kalian nggak pakai notes, kalian adalah edu Tuhan yang nggak pakai kertas ataupun nggak pakai laptop untuk mencatat. Yang harus kalian lakukan adalah melakukan pencatatan, dan kalian juga harus melakukan seluruh pencatatan yang benar-benar reasonable kepada kalian. Di saat itu, kalian pasti harus membuat namanya mapping. Ada namanya mapping di saat kalian buat fourth sama first yang di ranking itu. Mapping itulah di saat itu kalian bisa ngebuat namanya alasan kenapa dia bisa kalah in the fourth place, terus kenapa dia bisa menang, apa yang beda dari mereka. Mapping itu bakal berguna if you try to giving oral adjudication. So this happens in most of the time. Because you're trying to give him from fourth and then first, terus first-nya itu udah senang banget, wih, gue dapat first, dan kalian melihat reasonable-nya, okay, ya udah, you're giving 10 or maybe 9 or 8, and just being confident because of that. Because in international level, let's say there is UADC, or maybe there is WUDC, the most common that every debater dreams about. Di saat itu, kalian dapat first di lomba international. Tetapi ada salah satu debater, walaupun dia dapat first, dia bakal ngasih edu feedback yang rendah. Jadi ada misalnya debater saya itu from the high class, from let's say Amrita, or maybe Plupi, or maybe Brian O'Connor. Tiba-tiba kalian menjuri mereka, contohnya. Terus kalian kasih dia first, tetapi malah di edu feedback dia kasih rendah 4 atau 3. It happens. Jadi walaupun kalian ngasih dia first, for example, it doesn't mean that he accepting the first and then see your reason is reliable. Ada yang nggak suka kalau misalnya kalian kasih dia first, tapi reasonnya nggak jelas. So be careful in oral adjudication and also be careful if you're adjudicating. Ini nggak nakut-nakutin, tapi ini pernah terjadi di beberapa lomba. Bahkan kalian bisa sampai rendah cuma gara-gara OA kalian itu memang nggak bagus. Padahal decision kalian itu sama chair yang lain atau panel yang lain. Jadi itu yang hati-hati di oral adjudication. Karena oral adjudication adalah core di mana kalian memberikan informasi kenapa every debaters get that ranking. Every debaters is not prominent to proceed, and every debater is prominent to proceed in that level of the competition. Jadi itu yang harus kalian jaga kalau misalnya untuk do oral adjudication. And the last part, when you try to be confident, whatever happens, whatever it takes, if you are chair, and then you're being demoted to panel, or even worst case scenario, you're being demoted to trainee, don't be afraid. Ada debater dengki yang bakal buat kalian rendah. Di saat itu, in the next round, you trace your time. You are tracing your sunshine, and then you show off that you are able to adjudicating. Bisa terjadi, karena ada juga chair yang turun ke panel, itu mungkin ya nggak masalah. Mungkin dia turun ke panel, karena panel dia itu mungkin bisa aja, dia turun ke panel, tetapi dia panel di high chamber. Bisa terjadi. Tadi dia nge-chair, terus jadi chair, terus dia sampai round di akhir. Tapi ada juga yang dari chair turun ke trainee, itu ada juga. That happens in my previous experience in NUDC 2018. Itu bakal terjadi. From chair to trainee, tiba-tiba di ronde selanjutnya. Makanya that happens if you see the reality. So, adjudicating is not you being an absolute subjective person. It means that you are able to give reasonable to those candidates. Karena itu yang harus paling penting di saat kalian adjudicating. Ini kan nggak adjudicating asal-asal, misalnya kalian, okay, kita menangin ini, dah. Habis itu, dengan unanimous decision, dia menang, okay. Tapi nggak ada alasan yang bukan kayak gitu. nggak kayak eju-eju yang simple, sesimpel itu. Karena kalian harus memberikan sebuah alasan yang tepat kenapa dia bisa sampai kalah, kenapa dia bisa sampai menang. Dan in the same time, every debater have right to judge you also in the same time. Karena debaters itu juga ada hak untuk menilai jurinya ini prominent apa enggak. So, train yourself with oral adjudication. If you want to training this oral adjudication, yang harus diingat adalah debat itu sendiri. Maksudnya dimaksudnya debat itu sendiri adalah ruang lingkup yang terjadi dalam mosi itu dan apa yang terjadi dalam debat itu. Setelah itu, kalian baru masuk bagaimana cara menjuri adalah melihat apakah dia itu bisa menang terhadap dari argumen ataupun dari sistem contribution yang dia berikan. If you are already debating for a long time, you will have that sense. Karena pasti ada sense di mana kalian, oh ini pasti kami bisa menang nih, kita bisa menang. Pasti ada kayak gitu, pasti ada aja sense yang kayak gitu. Karena itu sense yang dimiliki for all debaters, including me also. Bisa udah lama nggak debate, but I'm too much adjudicating, and then you doing debate, you will feel like, oh gue kalah nih. Ya, kayaknya dia bisa menang. There will be a sense like that. Di saat kalian ada sense like that, you have times and you are being prepared yourself to become adjudicating. Karena itu, di saat itu momen-momen yang dimana kalian rasakan confidence yang harus kalian punya, itulah yang maksud dengan confidence-confidence itu. It been trained, not coming from the, not only coming from the debating itself, but it will lead into the others. For example, di saat kalian debating, kalian lihat chair, masih result, di saat itu kalian ngerti bahwa, oh ini cara mencuri. It's okay, just take a note, whatever it is. Karena itu adalah momen yang betul-betul berguna bagi kalian untuk belajar adjudicating daripada ya lepas-lepas saja. Nah, if you are being prominent for debating, kalian udah menang lomba-lomba klasik nasional, misalnya kalian menang lomba Jofet, you're winning IFAT, you're winning NUDC, and then you're winning UADC, for example, if you're international class. You have right to become adjudicator in that time. Tapi ada juga debaters yang enggak cocok untuk adjudicating, ada juga debaters yang enggak cocok untuk debating, tapi setidaknya pernah ada track record debating. It's okay for you to do that. So those confidence that you need to be appearing from the beginning is necessary. It's necessary for all of you guys to be happy. Okay? And this is all the complete package that coming from me. So thank you very much. If you have any question answer, I would like to give it to moderator, I guess. Thank you.
Okay, sir. Wow, that's really great presentation, sir. I'm really appreciate it. But let's continue to next session, that is question and answer. Untuk sesi selanjutnya ialah tanya jawab. Para peserta dapat memberikan pertanyaan melalui kolom chat dan dapat mengisi link asensi dari Saudara Yuda. Saudara Yuda dapat membagikannya di kolom chat agar peserta dapat mengisinya.
Oh yeah, if you have a question and answer, you are likely to do it. Unmute yourself. It's okay. Just open your mic. Maybe dikasih ya kalau misalnya unmute aja kalau bisa mau nanya.
Okay. You can open mic if you have a question. For all attendance.
Oh. Oh, dear.
Untuk linknya sudah dibagikan dalam kolom chat, para peserta dapat mengisinya.
Okay, so I guess there's no questions coming from you, all of you guys.
We ask once again, any question?
Yeah. Oh, Lord. Dan kau usah takut guys, aku nggak gigit kok untuk pertanyaan. It's okay.
Sir, may I ask a question?
Oh yeah, sure.
What is interesting moment being a debater?
I'm sorry, sir.
What is interesting moment being debater?
The interesting moment if you are debaters, you win. That's the moment. That's the most interesting things that happen. Of course, if you're winning, apalagi kalian bisa menang. Misalnya kalian lomba debat, terus kalian melawan misalnya kayak, okay, let's say there's a cases kalian melawan Bang Khotma. Kalian satu round bersama Bang Khotma dan sama Bang Husni, contohnya. Dan kalian melihat bahwa Bang Khotma dan Bang Husni kan udah prominent debate yang udah sampai berapa puluh tahun. Enggak berapa puluh tahun, dia tua kali nampaknya. Beberapa tahun, ya kan? Dan di saat itu kalian bisa menang melawan debater tua. Yang juga sebenarnya dia bisa punya prominent to go nationals. That's the most things that will be satisfied. Itu bakal yang lebih hal-hal yang memuaskan. Kalau misalnya kalian debater. Tapi itu ya cuma bonusnya aja kalian bisa menang. But the three point is you are able to learn a lot dari orang-orang itu sendiri. Karena kalau misalnya kalian debate, di saat kalian buat your own argument, ada momen di saat kalian itu bakal melihat argumen musuh itu menjadi salah satu knowledge baru bagi kalian. Dan kalian bisa implementasikannya di di saat musim-musim lainnya hampir sama. Mungkin itu sih, kalau misalnya momen-momen yang enak. Oh, okay. That's a question.
Yes, from Wahyu, sir. Thank you, Chair Angga, for your valuable information. I want to ask, what will you do as an adjudicator when you don't understand at all? That's the question.
Ini jahat. Ini sih jahat sih sebenarnya. Kalau misalnya you don't know motion
atau satu-satu, sir.
Kayaknya satu-satu aja deh, boleh ya? Biar lebih asik aja. Jadi untuk Wahyu, halo Wahyu, makasih udah datang. So if you're adjudicator, terus kalian nggak ngerti motionsnya, it's evil for you if you don't understand. It's okay sebenarnya. Karena ada momen misalnya kayak let's say this house believes that Ocean Pacific will be more likely being owned by the China. Terus kalian nggak ngerti kemana kok bisa China punya Pacific Ocean or sector. Contohnya, ada mosi-mosi yang halusinasi yang bahkan kalian nggak cocok ke otak kalian. Kalau misalnya, if you don't understand motion at all, you need to see the debate itself. Kalian harus melihat debatnya itu cemana. Apa sih proses perjalanan debatnya itu sendiri. Kalau misalnya kalian nggak ngerti pun mosinya, kalian melihat dan juga mendengar sampai telinga kalian itu peka cemana debatnya itu berjalan. Dan kalian harus mengetahui alur debatnya itu sendiri. So when you don't understand the motion, you have to learn a lot, dan kalian baru connect-kan, oh ini kontribusinya cocok nggak sama argumen yang diberikan. So I think that's the biggest point, kalau kalian nggak ngerti itu sama lain. But please don't understand the motions, karena itu hal krusial bagi adjudicator. Walaupun kalian sampai searching, harus kalian sampai searching. Kalau misalnya kalian nggak tahu, kan ada waktu 15 menit tuh kan, kalian searching aja tuh motionnya apa maksudnya. Itu jahatnya, sampai kalian nggak ngerti apa-apa. Mungkin itu sih, oke. Mudah-mudahan terjawab ya, Wahyu.
Thank you for answering, sir. And the next question from Jessica, sir. what is a general criteria for us to get upper position, for example, like from training upper to panel or chief? Because I have experience, like I get some decision and also reasonable until third round, but I'm still in trainee position.
Okay, that's okay. General criteria yang harus kalian lakukan if you want to go upper positions. It happens if you are trainee, karena aku juga pernah trainee, dan trainee itu sucks. Karena, I don't know, there's a little bit gimmick and there's a little bit stereotype that trainee is just a new adjudicator, and then you just think that those kind of trainee doesn't know to adjudicating. So the general criteria is you need to find the attention. You need to giving a reasonable, like until a chair very understandable with your reason. Let's say that if you're trainee and then pas main segen-segen kalau misalnya trainee kayak ini decision aku terus decisionnya sama. Okay, cool. Terus tiba-tiba reasonable-nya itu you are understand your reasons. You are giving your reasons very fluctuative. And then it feels like your reason is much more reliable and understandable. Maybe there's a part of chair that seems that the reasons it's okay, but need to be more analysis on why you want to see the tipping point or maybe the bigger picture of why you will able to win. I think those the part of you need to be understandable. Like why, I'm very sorry if you say that if you're still in training, just because those kind of parts. Ada juga chair yang cuma ngelihat bahwasannya, oh ya ini decision-nya tepat, tapi aku nggak betul apa is the reasons-nya. Ada sih chair-chair agak jahat gitu. Tapi sekarang itu pasti nggak lagi sih sebenarnya. Karena kayak if you are trainee, you will giving have a chance to giving your decision. But there's a time where trainee will have your reasons, walaupun waktu kalian sikit. Waktu kalian sikit itulah yang harus kalian package general comment and then the reasons and ranking in a very smaller time. Yes, it is. Jadi kalian harus membuat seluruh reasonables yang misalnya di diskusi itu punya 15 menit, kalian as a trainee coba package in the small sampai judges-nya mengerti dan reasonables dalam waktu 5 menit, for example. Jadi hal-hal kayak gitu yang membuat chair bakal lebih menyukai hal-hal kayak gitu. Walaupun ya, I know, I'm very sorry with your experience, but keep on the good spirit. Pasti akan ada chair yang ngasih kalian tinggi. Okay, I think that's all.
Thank you, sir. And the next question by Sidi Wijaya. He asked, I want to ask, sir, is hand movement in debating important? And will the judges think that is in something that every debater should do?
Oh, okay. So the question is kind of vague. Vague-nya tuh maksudnya kayak agak rancu. Karena kayak hand movement in debating, it's okay. Karena kayak judges itu bakal nggak menjuri itu sih. Karena kayak hand movement itu hal yang lumrah dibawa. Let's see, I'm just moving my hands. Because ya, ini hal lumrah menurut aku. Ini adalah triggering part for me to think deeper, for example. And it's triggering me to giving a proper argument. Jadi di saat ini hand movement yang aku buat ini, ya, they're not being part of the judges. Karena ya pasti ini hal-hal yang mereka coba untuk men-trigger isi argumen yang mereka punya, contohnya. Ataupun mereka men-trigger, tadi itu argumen yang aku catat, itu asalnya ada extension-nya, tapi aku lupa. Jadi, it's just triggering itself. So, it's not part of the scoring, tenang aja. The hand movement itu salah satu yang nggak di-adjudicating, dan kalaupun every debater ngelakuin, ya nggak masalah. Ya, nggak ngelakuin nggak masalah, kalau ngelakuin juga nggak masalah. I think just seeing from how the argument is it. Okay, I hope it answer with Sigi Wijaya.
Okay. Thank you, sir, for answering. Next question for Vanes Pratama. Good morning, sir. I want to ask, when you be debater, have you been with the unfair judges? How you react that judges? Thank you.
Pernah. That's my experience in 2018. So in 2018, I'm debating in National University Debating, and I meet unfair judge that means that his or her reason is not fit with who I expected. Itu aja dulu yang pertama. Misalnya kayak kalian dapat 4, okay, you have the sense, kalian bakal dapat 4. Ya, it's okay, you get the 4. Decision dia benar, contohnya. Dia ngasih 4, 3rd, 2nd, 1st itu benar. Tetapi tiba-tiba dia itu unfair ngasih reason. Reasonnya cuma kayak, lu dapat 4 karena lu gak pandai bawa argumen ini. Okay, next. Itu hal-hal yang membuat personality yang like, oh my god, this is very unfair. Terus ada juga kok judges yang buat aku kayak, dia tuh ngasih aku 4 di saat aku punya possibility goes to first. Nah, itu ada lagi kayak gitu. Terus react-nya itu adalah, ya, yang hal-hal paling pertama adalah gibahin dulu. Setelah digibahin, ya, kalian datangin dia. To be a good debater, you need to find the feedback. You need to find the tipping point where I lost. Itu dulu. Kalaupun dia udah ngasih feedback, pasti kita udah ngasih feedbacknya udah luas kan. Misalnya kalian buat dah 2 contohnya, udah jahat lah kalian. Ya udah, biarin aja. Terus kalian minta feedback, ternyata feedback dia itu pun enggak benar, enggak reliable, dan enggak rasional untuk didengarkan. Ya, kalian langsung kayak, hah, ngeju kok bisa sih ngejuri aku pas contohnya kayak gitu. Ada, enggak apa-apa. Jadi kalau if you meet these unfair judges, the thing is, you need to learn a lot and hear a lot from what his feedback is. That's the first thing. And then the second is when you're asking a lot of the question to him, you need to understand what happens in reality, yang sebenarnya itu yang terjadi. Bahkan ada moment di saat, bahkan bukan kalian aja yang nggak terima. Ternyata bench-bench lain nggak terima. Itu terjadi. Dan langsung di saat itu, kalau misalnya kalian jahat, kalian doakan dia, terus ya udah dia care awalnya, terus jadi terimi. Yeah, this happens. This happens. Terus ya react judges-nya, yaudah, judges-nya. Ya, kalau jahatnya itu yaudah, sekarang lah kok udah gak pernah ngejuri, training lah kok memang patutnya, kayak gitu. This happens. And, yeah, I'm involved with that. Thank you for Vanessa Pratama.
From my heel, sir. Spill the tea. Sir, siapa hernya?
Gak boleh. Wahyu, kau. Mentang-mentang kita satu romba kita ya. Oke, okay, lanjut. Fadil.
Fadil, open mic atau questionnya sometimes I have a problem to analyze when the argument can be exclusive and then when we can say the rebuttal that the debaters did is actually success to do, and then how to make sure we can give the same burden to all the debaters while sometimes we still tend to be subjective only to certain bench.
Sometimes I have a problem with analysis when the argument can be exclusive and we can say the rebuttal that the debaters did is actually success to do, and then how to make sure we can give some same burden to all debaters while sometimes we still tend to subjectively on to certain page. Ini juga berat, karena kayak when you see the argument can be exclusive, itu di saat one, the argument is not being broken down until the fundamental itself. Yang dimaksud adalah dari awal sampai akhir, argumen dia itu solid dan tidak ada yang bisa ngeribat. Contohnya argumen yang it's not entirely perfect, pasti ada yang nggak perfect. Misalnya kayak argumennya itu dia udah nyiapin analisis pro-kontra. Misalnya analisis di bench opening government. Contohnya opening government ngasih analisis se-eksklusif apa argumen mereka sampai mereka menjadikan preemptive. Preemptive itu di saat kalian itu mencegah opening opposition ataupun opposition bench untuk merebuttal argumen kalian. Nah, di saat kalian udah melihat analisisnya itu, kalian juga melihat bahwasannya argumen-argumen yang dia bawa itu benar-benar contribute into the motions dan juga berhubungan dalam. Jadi, it's not as simple as bahwasannya iya dia benar karena logically dia baik. Nggak sesimple itu di argumennya itu. Karena bakal ada spices. Contohnya kayak spices yang dimaksud adalah salah satu hal-hal yang membuat dukungan argumen dia itu lebih solid. Contohnya kalau misalnya impeachment Trump, dia itu bakal bawa aktor yang sebenarnya kita nggak pikirkan. Contohnya, misalnya ada momen di saat ngejuri-ngejuri kayak gitu, kalian membawa bahwasannya on how in the current status quo China is being not reliable, is the part of the economic system. And then the impeachment Trump means that we have the power to control the world trade again. At the same time, they will also create a mitigations, including of how Saudi Arabia and then the Eastern Middle East. And in the same time, so try to save the good positions with the India tiba-tiba. Save yang jarang orang dengar, dan then argumennya itu benar-benar tepat. Di saat itu hal-hal kayak gitu yang sebenarnya juga problem analisisnya. Terus di saat kalian rebuttal, rebuttal yang sukses itu, I think that's the question. Ya. Jadi rebuttal yang sukses itu di saat kalian memberikan sebuah analisis analisis yang tepat. Kalau misalnya, I think most of you learned this, kalau misalnya rebuttal itu, if the statement coming from your enemy, A, let's say A, you're trying to change it into A minus. Itu aja yang paling mudah. Or, if you want to make it not A minus, you try to answer it with B. Maybe it's tough if you want to change a B. Tapi lebih enak tuh A minus. Misalnya kayak, iya, misalnya di bench kalian bilang, kita nggak mau ngelakuin impeachment karena Trump merupakan presiden yang sangat memukau. Dan dia itu presiden yang sangat membantu a good contribution to America. Because America, make America great again, contohnya. Di saat itu kalian buat bahwasanya, when the opposition say that they want to not impeachment Trump, we do the different things. We want to impeachment because we have to understand what happened in the current status quo, because the Trump create a very determined of discrimination. It doesn't solving the problem of racism. There's a lot of demonstrations that not being accessible and means that not being finished problem by those Trumps and etc. Jadi di situ yang rebuttalnya. Di saat itu kan mau taking point bahwasanya in that moment means that their argument is not valid as not going with success when the end of the day. And then how to make sure itu di saat kalian ngeliat road speakernya dulu. Kalau chamber den yang dimaksud itu adalah hal-hal yang paling lumrah atau paling-paling simpel. Contohnya cemana kalau misalnya debatersnya itu sendiri, if you see government member, kalian harus melihat different point of view dari prime minister. Karena itu yang harus dilakukan. Kalau prime minister kalian udah tahu role speakernya, kalian jangan samakan ke government member. Nah, itu dulu biar tend to be suggested to only certain bench. Jadi di saat kalian melihat hal-hal yang different, prime minister kayak mana harusnya, dan terus government member juga harusnya kayak mana, atau government whip harusnya kayak mana, kalian bakal lebih subjektif untuk menjuri. Karena pasti mereka udah mengenal role speaker mereka, yang apa yang harus mereka lakukan. Di saat itu kalian memberikan skor yang lebih tinggi, dan membuat debatnya itu lebih reliable in the end. Menurut aku itu, that's me coming personally, if you want to be a good adjudicating and giving the same burden to all debaters at the same time and reaching subjectivity. I think that's all for me. Thank you, Fadil Maulana. Good questions. Squish my brain.
Thank you for answering, sir. Okay, let's move next question from Renaldi. Renaldi, you may open your mic.
Your voice is a little bit small, but I think it's okay.
Okay, thank you so much for the opportunity. Saya mau tanya, Kak. Tim kita ngerasa kalau misalkan di tim kita itu kita lebih unggul, tapi pada saat result di round tersebut kita malah nggak sesuai dengan ekspektasi harapan kita dari tim kita. Nah ternyata jurinya bilang ada satu poin tertentu yang belum kita sebutkan. Padahal sebenarnya kita itu udah menyebutkan, tapi mungkin nggak secara mendalam gitu. Nah itu gimana sih Kak? Maksudnya kita ngadepin misalkan kasus seperti itu, karena pengalaman aku juga beberapa ikut kali lomba debat, aku sering menemukan juri yang seperti itu. Nah jadi kayak yang kita harusnya, menurut kita ya, maksudnya kayak kalau misalkan dibandingkan dengan juri-juri sebelumnya, mungkin kita lebih, ya misalkan di round pertama jurinya bilang kalau misalkan kita lebih capability daripada tim lain misalkan gitu, tapi ketika di round kedua kita udah, misalkan tim kita itu udah sesuai sebenarnya argumen, terus juga fakta-fakta yang kita sampaikan adalah memang kayak udah benar-benar kuat, tapi jurinya hanya karena kita mungkin belum menyampaikan secara detail, kalau dibilang secara detail mungkin kita menyampaikan secara detail, cuman waktu itu adalah tim lawan kita itu mungkin dia menyampaikannya lebih banyak, tapi kita lebih sedikit gitu. Nah, cuman itu gimana sih Kak, maksudnya kita menyikapi juri yang seperti itu? Apakah sebenarnya juri seperti itu dia hanya melihat apa ya, sisi tertentu di setiap timnya Kak, seperti itu? Itu sih Kak yang mau saya tanyakan, karena beberapa kali saya ikut debat, saya sering menemukan juri seperti itu. Terima kasih.
Ya, oke. Thank you, Ronaldi. Ya, it happens. Karena bakal ada juri-juri cheesy yang bakal bilang hal-hal kayak gitu. So, the cases that happens, kalau misalnya kayak ronde 1, you're being a prominent debater, contohnya. Mungkin ini pasti happens from different adjudicator pasti, ya kan? Pasti ronde 1 sama ronde 2 tuh jurinya beda. Kemungkinan. They say this happens in a different chair or maybe different adjudicators. Terus, kalian melihat di debat itu, you are able to win and be able to proceed, tapi di saat bersamaan, kalian melihat the results-nya itu nggak memuaskan. Bahkan di saat kalian mengira kalian dapat first, kalian dapat second aja pun nggak puas, contohnya. Terus, Eju cuma bilang, iya, kalian nggak deeper analysis di satu argumen yang menurut aku itu penting. Yes, it happens. Karena, kenapa? There's a part, bahwasannya, dia tuh melihat, Eju-Eju tuh mungkin melihat di debat itu sendiri. Contoh kalau misalnya, if you are the only team that bring a different idea, but the all benches agree in the same part, mungkin dia bakal bilang kayak gitu. Tapi kalau misalnya jurinya itu melihat bahwasannya there's only subjectivity, or maybe they just reality bahwasannya ada part yang dimana debaters-nya itu, let's say you guys have the prominent, tapi dia melihat bahwasannya tipping point-nya itu nggak ada. So it means that tipping point itu adalah tipping point di saat debatnya itu udah sesuai dengan mosi itu sendiri. Oke, okay. Maybe each adjudicator see a different tipping point. Pasti ada yang kayak gitu. So this is the toughest things that happens for all debaters. Makanya kalau misalnya dia melihat bahwasannya ada part yang dimana itu sebenarnya udah dibawa sama musuh, tapi menurut kita tuh nggak penting. Ada tuh, karena kita nggak harus ngerespon itu, karena itu kayaknya nggak cocok sama debatnya itu, kalau mungkin nggak cocok sama mosi itu sendiri. So, you left it out, but you bring your own argument that thinks that will be much more fit. Terus, judges ngasih kalian rendah gara-gara itu. It happens. Terus, karena itu point of view yang berbeda-beda dari juri. Gara-gara itu, sometimes those subjectivity itu jadi vague. Itu bakal terjadi juga. Jadi untuk menyikapinya, sometimes you have to ask the questions. Misalnya kalian, okay, mungkin worst case scenario-nya tuh kalian sampai dapat fraud, contohnya di ronde itu, ya, ronde 2 itu. Terus kalian menyikapinya, ya kalian tanya ke adjudicator-nya itu, kayak, can we know where is your tipping point? What is your subjectivity? Where is your tipping point? And then how you see the debate itself? Karena kami ngelihat debate-nya itu based on our argument gitu. Terus dia memberikan general comment-nya pasti ada yang di awal. Karena itu common question that happens in debater kalau misalnya dia kalah di awal. Nah, di saat kalian udah dapat bigger picture dari Eju-nya itu, ya you either accept it or maybe you either you decline it. Kalau decline, ditanya, loh bukannya ini lebih penting, karena gini. Nah, terus pasti juri itu try to give in, ya even that you're being important, tapi lihat dulu di seluruh bench. Kalau misalnya bench-nya itu sebenarnya udah agree in that part of the fundamental, dan mereka itu udah berdebat dalam satu ruang lingkup itu aja. Maybe you have the possibility to become a very exclusive that show up rather than all three benches. There's a possibility. Tapi ada juga judge yang melihat bahwasannya, oke, okay, ini kayak debatnya itu di ruang lingkup ini aja, tapi di saat mereka masuk ke tempat yang baru, I think it's good, but it's not credible to be credited. Ada juga yang kayak gitu. So I think the best statement is you asking those adjudicating, terus di adju feedbacknya itu ya you just giving comment apapun yang kalian bisa. Maksudnya pasti di adju feedback itu bisa kalian bisa melingkari 1-10, kalian bakal sih ada comment, maksudnya ya udah apa yang ingin kalian tanyakan ataupun comment kepada tender itu biasanya apa yang ingin kalian expect dari jurinya gitu-gitu semua. So be confident aja sih, nggak apa-apa kalau misalnya if you lost in round 2 doesn't mean that you lost in round 3 kan misalnya. I think it answer your question. Hmm. Oke, lanjutnya mungkin dari siapa nih? Oke, hope it answer Ronaldi. And I think, oke, Fadil lagi bertanya ya. For the last call, now let's say that if the A-level argument on A bench and B bench not really exclusive or just like normal argument, actually who is better on the chamber? Let's say the level argument on the A bench and the B bench, ya kalau misalnya BP masih ada C sama D bench sih. Tapi ya udah, misalnya kalau C sama D itu lebih eksklusif, mereka paling bisa, misalnya paling mudah menangin mereka. Tapi kalau misalnya komparatifnya misalnya A sama B, misalnya kalian nyari third sama fourth lah contohnya, mereka nggak eksklusif dan mereka nggak normal, so nothing special. Biasanya ada loophole yang bakal terjadi di bench dari A, si A sama B. Let's say A-nya itu walaupun dia nggak eksklusif, normal argument, nothing special, tapi dia bawa karakteristik contohnya. Dia bawa ROD, room of debate yang kayak mana. Dan di saat bersamaan dia giving a good responses. Tapi B-nya, si B, cuma bawa respon saja, yang dimana responsnya pun tuh nggak dalam-dalam kali. Jadi, in that time, I guess you able to see it from a different part. Karena kalian nggak harus bertatok sama argumen aja. Karena kalau argumen aja bertatok, ya yeah, it's cool, why not, gitu, bertatok sama argumen. Tapi ada burden yang bisa lebih membuat mereka untuk lebih berat. Contohnya kayak, si itulah, si characteristic, and then there's a rebuttals, and then story battles itu ada hal-hal lain, misalnya kayak room of debate, and then the solutions, result, impact, gitu-gitu semua, comparative of good and benefit, itu benefit and harm, gitu-gitu. Jadi di situ kalian bisa assess debating yang lain, selain dari argumen itu sendiri. Karena mungkin argumen itu cuma nge-state bahwasannya kita lebih baik daripada mereka, contohnya. Ataupun si argumennya adalah, we are able to do this kind of process because it's much more reliable to society, contohnya. Tapi nggak ada ngasih namanya result, nggak ngasih namanya process, there's no harm and benefit, no practicality, tapi cuma ada predictability how they happen in the arguments. Ya kayak gitu sih yang ngelihat bahwasannya adjudicator bakal melihat hal-hal kayak gitu. Karena bakal ada loophole yang bakal lebih besar lagi. Dan itu pasti burden dari setiap speaker untuk memenuhi itu. Dan di situ makanya role speaker yang tadi di awal dibilang harus dipenuhi. Karena ada hal-hal yang harus dipenuhi juga. Itu, I think it's answering for you, Fadil Maulana. Yay, yay, yay.
Okay, thank you for answering, sir.
Yup, yup. Thank you for all of you.
Maybe if I had a question for Fadil Maulana is the last. And okay, wah makasih banget nih sir udah jawab-jawab pertanyaan, banyak sekali pertanyaan.
Oke. Okay. Anytime.
Terima kasih sekali lagi Pak Angga Jepangka atas penyampaian materinya dan menjawab setiap pertanyaan yang sangat bermanfaat. Dalam hal ini dapat kita garis bawahi bahwa webinar pada hari ini untuk memberikan pengetahuan tentang we know about educate, especially in British and Asian, and how important roles of speaker and also being objective and no common knowledge for judging and basing educating. And the last, how to discussion. First, be brave, even your decision different with others, and you may ask feedback and get insight for other judge, just because it's okay have a different decision. That's the goals of decision. Nah, sekian dari seminar pada hari ini yang bertemakan How to Educate British Parliamentary Debate. Sekali lagi ucapan terima kasih pada pemateri yaitu Pak Angga Jepangka sekaligus buat Sir Ma selaku Presiden MDF yang dapat menghadiri webinar pada hari ini. Kami sangat terhormat dapat bergabung dan mendapatkan pengetahuan lebih lagi. Semoga sehat selalu dan sukses. Sekian untuk acara pada pagi hari ini. Terima kasih kepada para peserta dan panitia dan diharapkan apa yang kita jalankan hari ini semoga dapat membantu teman-teman semua dalam hal keilmuan serta pengalaman. Semangat untuk semuanya. Apabila ada kesalahan, mohon dimaafkan kami dari panitia. Ucapkan terima kasih. Selamat siang. Wabillahi taufik. Wa hidayah. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.